We are live on campus during the annual Renaissance Carnival to report yet another sighting of the mysterious creature that has been rumored to haunt this university for the past several years. I have a few eyewitnesses here with me now.
It happened late last night. I saw it swing down from somewhere, land in the bushes, and eat what I believe to be an owl.
It looked like a 250-pound baked potato.
I saw it a few years ago. It was dragging a mattress across the roof of the Fine Arts Building. It sat down and began chewing on the corner.
It looked like a small, giant hippopotamus, but its legs weren't that thick. They were more like human legs, but thinner, and its head wasn't as big as a hippo's. It was different.
I don't know. I think it's probably just some extremely ugly, heavy-set teacher wearing a bear suit and antlers or something. That's what the teachers around here do sometimes when the stress gets to them, you know? This is my girlfriend, Kathy. She loves television. You should really talk to her. Come back here. I have an important appointment at 2 with the dean, and it's 3:30. It's 3:30. I have to go.
Bye.
I'll see you later at the dorm. Okay, I'll see you later. Bye. See you later.
Well, Kathy, what do you think about all this creature business?
Well, I don't really believe in it, but there's been so much talk about it lately that sometimes I feel like I'm being watched.
Thank you very much.
Sorry about the next
15. Mr. Kaminsky, I have before me your final grades from last term. It appears that once again you have proven to be an underachiever.
Apparently, underachievement is the only area in which you excel.
Well, actually, sir, to be perfectly honest, for a while I was suffering from a lack of direction.
Kaminsky, you are a barnacle on the great ship of knowledge, and the time is nearing for you to be scraped off. If you do not earn a B average this term, I will have no recourse but to flunk you out. Today.
Falawa! Oh. Now.
Do you realize if I flunk out, my dad is going to jerk my butt back to New Jersey, where I will be forced to slave
in Kaminsky's furniture store, the store in which everything is plastic, including my parents.
Alex, you are one of the brightest people I know. Your main problem is that you're just a little bit unfocused.
And what about us?
Alex, getting depressed about it is not going to make matters any better.
I enjoy being depressed. It's an inexpensive way of showing oneself a bad time.
And now for our final contestant for the winner of this year's Campus Renaissance Carnival, here's Miss Laura Stevens. Now tell us, Laura, what does a college education mean to you?
Okay, like if you're real dumb, you know, and something real bad happens, like a nuclear war, and your TV won't work, or it's real dark and you can't find your makeup. Well, if you're, like, educated, maybe you can figure out something to do.
I have shoes that are smarter than her. Hey, jerk face. That happens to be my girlfriend. Oh, sorry. You know what? I'm on medication for enlarged pores, and it just kind of makes me crazy. I mean, actually, your girlfriend is quite attractive for a girl. For anyone, for that matter.
She's beautiful,
isn't she?
Okay, folks, we're going to take a 5-minute breather here and let the judges make their final decisions. So just hang tight, and we'll be back in a second with the results.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Steve.
Well, I see you're still hanging around with Mr. Excitement here. Kaminsky, tell me something. What is this magical hold that you have over this beautiful woman?
Let's back off, Steve, okay?
Hey! Here we go.
I'm so sorry. Again, I'm sorry. You know what?
I'm having a bad day. No? And it's about to get worse.
I think that makes us about even, don't you?
Guess again.
I promised my parents this time I'd try to avoid getting beaten to death.
Aren't you going to do something?
I'd like to, but you know, I kind of think he's learning a life lesson. You know, it's going to be valuable to him at some later date.
Hey, relax.
We'll just leave it.
Where do you think he came from?
I don't know. New York?
That's her! That's the animal's girlfriend!
Miss Adams?
Yeah.
How you doing? Mr. Kaminsky?
Kaminsky,
sorry. I'm Miles Cohen, the court-appointed defense attorney.
Oh.
Follow me. I'll take you to the East Courtroom.
Great.
Can we see him first?
Okay, kid. Here he is.
Wow, he looks so nice in his jacket, doesn't he? It's a joke. It's a joke.
Can I say hello?
Yeah. Don't get him aggravated.
Hi.
Hi.
Kathy. He understands.
No, not really. He just repeats things.
Oh, great. So what we have here is the world's largest parrot, correct?
Correct.
Correct.
In the matter of John Doe?
Your Honor, this is a hearing pursuant to the Mental Health Act of the State of California to determine whether John Doe is of sufficient mental capacity to manage his own affairs.
Where is the respondent, John Doe?
He's on his way in, Your Honor.
All right.
All chained up like that?
I think it's to prevent him from eating the courtroom.
Okay, let's have your first witness.
Hey!
What's going on?
What the hell's going on here, Mr. Cohen?
He's a little nervous, Your Honor, but he'll be fine.
He'll be fine.
It's all right.
Once he's down, he's down.
Thank you, Mr. Cohen.
He'll be fine now.
Fine now.
I think he just likes my perfume.
Let's get started, Mrs. Johnson, please.
Your Honor, the prosecution calls Dr. Victoria Fisk. The subject has obviously had little or no human contact. He suffers from a complete inability to relate to people. His motor responses are erratic. His temperament is unpredictable and occasionally violent in nature. The combination of these factors, coupled with his already evident savage behavior, make it imperative that he be institutionalized at once. The defendant is, unquestionably, a menace to society.
The defense calls Miss Kathy Adams.
Kathy?
I believe the defendant came from wherever he came from because he thought somebody was trying to hurt me. I mean, the only time he ever did any physical harm to anybody was either to help me or protect himself.
Your Honor, we have no way of determining what the respondent had in mind, if anything.
Kathy.
The defense calls Dr. Richard Webster of the psychology department at the university.
Your Honor, like Dr. Fisk, I've only briefly examined the respondent, and I feel at this point it would be very unfair to make any final judgment. Now, my colleagues and I have persuaded the university to allow us to test, examine, and to possibly rehabilitate this poor, unfortunate creature. Our hope is to give him the opportunity to better demonstrate the full extent of his capabilities.
With all due respect, Your Honor, the defendant has already demonstrated the full range of his abilities.
It is obvious what we have here is a clear-cut difference of opinion.
Your Honor, if you have any further questions, I suggest that the defendant take the witness stand.
The witness may take the stand.
Do you swear that the testimony you're about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God? If so, answer yes.
Yes.
Don't be deceived, Your Honor. The defendant only appears to understand. Actually, he just repeats the last few sounds that he hears. May I show you something?
Yes, you may.
Who do you think is better qualified to determine your ultimate fate, Dr. Webster or Dr. Fisk?
Dr. Fisk.
Fine. Now, let me ask you, which are you, a wise man or a complete and total fool?
Complete and total fool.
It gives me no pleasure to render my verdict. However, the evidence leaves me no choice. The defendant shall be remanded to the custody of the sheriff to be confined in a mental facility for his protection and the protection of others.
Your Honor, I really don't think this is fair. I mean, you haven't even seen...
Let's go.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, Judge Ferguson.
And as a result of that dramatic moment, Judge Ferguson has awarded temporary custody of the hunchback to the university under the supervision of Dr. Richard Webster. However, the judge has set forth one condition. Should the defendant exhibit any violent or disruptive behavior, he will immediately be institutionalized.
Miss Adams, will you be participating in this experiment?
I'm going to help in any way I can. Mr. Kaminsky, how do you fit into the picture?
Very carefully. No, actually, I'm going to be his manicurist.
I am certain that the creature is a time bomb ready to explode. I would stake my reputation on that.
I think you just have. Reporting live from the courthouse, this is...
I didn't know this was live. Could I rephrase that?
Doctor, I have to go talk to the
hunchback. I stake my reputation. I think that's going a little far. Couldn't I just say if it's